blessings to you, and let us come together to rejoice and to celebrate. Let us at this time join our hearts together as we invite the presence of the Lord in our midst, even though we are not here together as one body. We are scattered in various places, but let's join our hearts together as we celebrate, as we sing, and as we remind ourselves of the true meaning of Christmas. Let us pray and commit this time together. Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for the wonderful opportunity that we have as your people to gather together in this fashion. Although there are limitations around us, I thank you, Lord, that we have the opportunity to invite your presence in our midst, even in the midst of difficulty. Because as two or three gather together in your name and agree, you promise to be in our midst. And this evening, as we gather together and as we celebrate, Father, I pray that your presence will be so real wherever we are. Your presence will just touch us, minister to us. And the true joy of Christmas we will begin to understand and experience at this very moment. Father, we just commit this entire program to your loving and gracious hands. We pray that everything that we do will bring glory to you. Everything that we do will magnify your name, and it will remind us of the real presence of the Holy One, Lord Jesus himself, in our midst. And this time we just commit ourselves together and commit everything that we have in store. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and ask. Amen.
Hey church family, a merry, merry Christmas to you. Even though we can't meet in person, we want to welcome you to the online service, A Thrill of Hope. I pray that you have a great time with your family. God bless you.
Light of the world, Lord. So glad that you have joined us from your homes as we have from ours to present to you our 2020 Christmas program, A Thrill of Hope. We do hope that you will join us in singing as we do for you this evening.
Jesus, Emmanuel, how Hey church, we know that we are doing Christmas in a bit different this time. We are at home, so wherever you are, just grab the person next to you and sing this song with us as we celebrate this wonderful season of Christmas.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing on the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Scripture reading is from the book of John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. The Word became flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the word of the Lord.
Well, church, it's that time of the year again where you and I come across memes about the song Mary, Did You Know? And if you are active on social media these days, you would see there's a meme going around where one person asks, Mary, did you know? And she's like, yes, Gabriel told me. But I want to open your eyes to something new. There is a strong message in this song, Mary, Did You Know? And when Gabriel met Mary, he told Mary that you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will be the Son of the Most High God. And this song will open our eyes to the things that Jesus did to bring glory to God. So prepare yourselves, and I want your full attention on the song that the children of Calvary Centre are going to sing, Mary, Did You Know? Be blessed.
Soon deliver you. Can you hear the angel's song that runs so sweet and clear? When heaven's light and music fell and mercy found us here. Glory in the highest and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the angels sing. He came to tell the Father's love, His goodness and His grace, to show the brightness of His smile, the glory of His face. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, your children sing. His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be.
He came to lift the weary ones, give peace and perfect rest, to take away our burdens and to give glorious gifts. To glory in the highest, on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the world is
ending. His name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, for all eternity. For all eternity, oh, His name shall be.
One name above all others, one name that came to save us. Oh, sing His name.
Something we all miss about in-person service is the time of fellowship that we have afterwards. Most of us look forward to it. And whilst many of us are in our little groups chit-chatting, there's another bunch that are so active. You won't find them in one place, probably running around. And next up, we have the kids of our church to give you their best moves.
there was one good thing that we were able to do in the year 2020 amidst all the challenges, it was that it gave most of us the opportunity to set our priorities right. Right? Priorities. Very important. Even as we step into a new year, I'm sure most of you are looking forward to setting your priorities right one more time. And here we have the Radical Generation, the young adults group of Calvary Centre, who have prepared a small drama to communicate a powerful message about setting your priorities right. It's going to be fun. It's going to be amazing. So give it your full attention and be blessed.
Can you pray for my son? He's going through a very tough time. From morning till night, he's working. Can you pray for the marriage, please, sister?
Don't say like that, sister. Don't worry.
Yeah, Jennifer, you don't understand the stress I'm going through today and night. Huh? I'm a dog waiting for you. Please pray with you.
Okay, okay. I'll pray for you, sir.
So. Pray for Hello?
Hi, Auntie. Did I disturb you? Prayers, no? Sorry to disturb you, Auntie. You know how baby is today. She's troubling a lot. Whatever it is, like, you know, your son's time, no? So, can't change that. Anyway, Auntie, I want to pray. I'm sorry to trouble you. It's very sunny. And I did my skin treatment. I can't go out in the sun and all that. So can you please, since you're anyway coming now, I hope you get late, but anyway, since you're anyway coming, can you bring 500 grams of sugar? Come, there's no sugar to make tea or anything. Okay, darling, you're the best mother-in-law. Okay, bye.
Yo, madam, I'm not going to get it. I'm not going to get it.
I was going for you. Yeah, I saw a cute fellow, right? Why don't you send me the link? I can't follow like that. Maybe you just tell that he's, you know, you're one of like my friends and him. You send the link. Then I will end. Can at least look at the fellow room and not that we are going to go and marry this fellow room. Sweet, nah? I know, I'm just looking. I can look at it all day long. Oh, yeah, such a cute fellow. What a sweet baby.
Can you stop this? I have had enough of this. I want a divorce.
Ding ding.
What's that? Think it's faster. Kamala? Kamala? Now don't have to have problems. Wait, like we have a happy family. Let's sort our problems later.
Hi, brother.
Hi, Pastor. How are you?
Hi, sister. Praise the Lord.
Hi, Pastor.
Excuse me, I just came after badminton.
Come, sit down, Pastor. Sit down.
So, how are you all? How is your family?
We're good, Pastor.
Because your mother was such a faithful lady. Tuesday prayer, she runs it. You know how loving she is. Isn't she around?
She's gone for the prayer meeting, Pastor.
She must be there. My wife is also there. It's okay. Sister, you want to go for women's ministry?
Baby, tiring,
past. Okay, that is good, sister. You need to prioritize yourself. God first, family second, anything else third. So tell me, what have you all been up to?
Working, Pastor, working, and also I was this close, Pastor. I was telling this woman here, you know, I'm going to divorce her.
What is this? Wait. What is this? You tell me your side will.
Let him inside prayer pass and he knows end all these problems. I have no problems. I'm a happy woman.
Go ahead, brother. Tell me.
For morning pastor, she's on the phone. Calling this person, that person, the other. I'm working, I'm dependent on the child. For like, she's not dependent.
You are the one who takes the child. As the child gets up, you come and take the child and go.
I take the child because...
So I let you be. You love the child so much.
I take the child because...
Wait. There is only a small solution for this. You all need to prioritize yourself. You don't have to go for women's ministry all the time. If you have problems at home, solve them. Be with the child. Why can't you go and take the baby sister first? Why do you have to wait for him? This season is about family. Why can't you all be together? It's not about finding the easy way out. You all need to go through everything. You all need to get the experience. So, what I'm telling is, you all need to work this out between yourselves. Do not drag in your mother-in-laws and all that.
My mother is a very good woman.
Wait. Let's leave them out of it. They are not here yet. No. So you all take your time and talk about it. I will leave now. I just came to look, check on how you all are doing. I will go and come. You all should work this out. I think you all can do this. I'm just getting a message on my iPad for my next badminton match. I will go.
And faster, prepare
some tea
for you.
Pastor, before you go, just pray first, Pastor.
Oh, I am so sorry, brother, sister. Come, I will pray for you all. Okay, let's pray. Lord, we thank you, Father, for this time. Lord, we thank you for this family, Father. We thank you for how amazing you've been, Father. No matter what happens, you are the center of it all, Lord. And Lord, what you have put together, no man can break, Father. And Lord, I pray for your will to be upon this family, Father, and that your touch will be upon this family, Lord. And Lord, I pray for everyone watching on the video. Bless them, Lord. Let them come to you, Father. Let them find you this season, and let this season be about love, giving, peace and joy, Father. We thank you so much for all that you're doing, and I thank you for this united family that's going to be with you from now onwards, Father. As they put aside their differences, that they will walk with you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. See you, brother. I have to. Corona, no, brother.
Yes.
See you, sister. Come on, sister.
Oh, very tired. Come on, come to the shugango.
Shugango.
Oh, what's this? Both of you seated in the afternoon meeting. No, walk for you! Go, the top is first, no?
No, Amma, don't talk like that. After all, family comes first. Pastor also was saying that God comes first, then family and then other ministries. He can pray first also. Even praying alone won't come right. You guys also need to support us by not putting your fingers into this marriage. And also, this Christmas, family is the main thing.
Name I like in this. Jennifer, can I come and stay with you at your place tonight? I can't do this.
I think Arjun did an amazing job in displaying to us the beauty of art. Despite that humor, it left us with that vital message of priorities. How timely. Next up, to keep up with the Christmas cheer and their own spirits, are the teens of Reflection Youth Ministries with their version of Christmas Day. It will sure keep your toes tapping and fingers snapping. Hope you enjoy.
Emmanuel, God is with us. Good evening. We want to warmly welcome you to our Christmas presentation by Calvary Centre Ja-Ela again. A thrill of hope, and the world, weary world, rejoices. This hymn that we sung so much at Christmas time was composed in 1845. We sing it so many times, we have heard it so many times, but these four words, "A weary world rejoices," slips our mind. We don't think about it so much. But yet, when you look at the real Christmas story, and with the events of 2020, the weary world rejoices is the Christmas message for this year. We see, you know, when we started this year, we wished each other a very good year. But in March, the pandemic broke out. Most of our social gatherings, most of our normal duties went haywire. We had to start working from home, studying from home, socially distancing ourselves from those whom we love and we care. And even now, as we come to the 20th of December, we are wondering whether we will ever get to have those same fun times, the family times, the fellowship times that we normally have during this festive season. We are all weary from the lockdowns. We are weary from wearing masks and doing sanitization and being careful of where we stand, with whom we stand, so on and so forth, and how we travel about, even in public transport. The world is weary, not knowing what is going to happen next. Some people are even thinking of cutting down on their frolic on Christmas Day, their family times on Christmas Day, because everything has changed in 2020. And therefore, I believe the weary world rejoices is a good theme that we can reflect upon this evening. Since the fall of mankind, we see that the Jewish people were awaiting for their Messiah. They experienced slavery, famine, war. They spent years wandering in the desert, and they were looking forward, especially after the captivity in Babylon, when will their king arrive? They spent 400 years of silence, of dark ages, where they did not know where the answer was going to come. And then suddenly, the Christmas story on the day of our Savior's birth, he brought with him, as the song says, a thrill of hope. The world is weary, but Christ brings a thrill of hope. The reason is, you see, the hope we find in Christ Jesus is real. Just like the suffering we experience is real. Just like the change of times that we are experiencing is real. Just like every value in our families and in our homes and our societies have changed, and we have to face with reality. The reality in that the world is going to be different. People are already talking about the new norm. people are saying, okay, this is how it is going to be. So as much as that is a reality, the hope that Christ brings at Christmas is a reality. That's why we are able to title our message and our program, A Thrill of Hope as the Weary World Rejoices. The reason is Christ brings hope. Just as he brought hope 2,000 years ago, just as the angels came and told the shepherds, behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. Even after 2020, we can still say that the birth of Christ brings goodwill to all men, brings peace on earth, brings a good news to all people, not necessarily to Christians. The reason is, man's real problem is sin. The world is experiencing the results of man's disobedience. Man, the crown creation of God. And therefore, the whole earth, the creation itself, is under the curse. And it is, in the book of Romans, I believe it says, it is groaning and waiting for the day of redemption. So, in a weary world, Christ brings a thrill of hope. Why? Because very soon, he is going to come. We have been, for 2,000 odd years, we've been celebrating the 25th of December as the birth of Christ, as the arrival of the Son of God, Emmanuel, God being with us. But hardly do we realize that as every Christmas passes, we are drawing close to the second coming of our King. The day when he will make all the imperfections perfect, where he will bring peace on earth, lasting peace, where he alone will make the world prosperous, where he alone will take away the enmity so the little child can sleep near the lion. This evening, my dear friend, my question to you is, you can experience the thrill of hope of Christmas, even though you are weary, even though you are sad, even though you may have lost somebody in the pandemic, even though you may have lost your job in pandemic, even though you may have to have moved from where you were to where you are today because of the pandemic, Christ brings a thrill of hope. And that's the message we have for you. Now, how do you do that? You do that by committing your life to Jesus. Because he alone is the constant person or constant thing in a changing world. My Bible tells me, yesterday, today, and forever, Jesus is the same. He never changes. The hope he offers has not changed. He in fact said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you hope and rest. And this evening, that's what we as a church are offering to the community in Ja-Ela, to the western province of Sri Lanka, to the nation of Sri Lanka, and to the nations of the world. The thrill of hope in Christ, even as the world is weary today. How does that happen? It happens when you accept the Prince of Peace, who was born 2,000 years ago in that lowly manger in Bethlehem, into your heart. It's not about changing religions. It's about accepting and getting to know the Savior of the world. It's about asking God for all the sins, iniquities, and transgressions you may have done knowingly or unknowingly right through your life and receiving a full pardon from him and living a free life. It means giving to him all your addictions, all your slaveries, and obtaining the peace and the freedom that he brings. This evening, God, through this telecast, is offering you that opportunity to have the thrill of hope. The world outside is weary. The world outside is blank. The world outside is gloomy. The world outside is thinking, what is going to take place in 2021? But you and I can know and experience that thrill of hope. As the hymn says, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. And when you accept Jesus as your personal Savior this Christmas, which is the real meaning of Christmas. It's not about the tree. It's not about the decor. It's not about the turkey in the oven. It's not about any of those things. It's Christ living in me. And when you experience that, when you experience the new birth, when you experience the forgiveness of sins, when you experience, everything changes. Perspective changes. The way you look at things changes. And 2021 is going to be a great year, because the storms may come, the winds may blow. He will never let go of your hand. He will hold on to you. He will be the anchor for your boat, so that your life will not sink, but sail through the proper destination. My friend, I'm inviting you today, as we bring this message to a close, I'm inviting you today to bow your hearts to the Lord wherever you are. and say, Jesus, come into my heart this Christmas and bring this thrill of hope that this pastor is talking about. May the Lord bless you as you continue to enjoy our program today and also continue to celebrate Christmas with your friends and family. I pray sincerely that 2020 you will be able to finish well, and 2021 will be a great year in your life, in your family's life, and in your future. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Hi, church. It feels so warm and special to come into your homes and to share Christmas with you this season. Let us always remember that Jesus is the perfect peace, no matter what situation you are in.
Thrill of hope, the view.
I'm sure you enjoy the beautiful carols speaking about the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the message that Pastor Mohan brought to us was very, very challenging. So we want you to be blessed at this Christmas, even though we are still in this pandemic. So shall we bow our heads in prayer as we pray. Father in heaven, although it has been an unexpected year to us, and as we end this year and still remember that you brought hope and salvation and peace above all things to mankind, we pray that every individual and every family who has received you into their hearts and lives, that they will enjoy this peace. Even you said, Lord, in those days, in the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world, and my peace will be yours. So bless every family, meet every need of theirs, and be with them as they step into the new year. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. May the Lord bless you and have a great season.